It's Dr. Amanda with Straits Mouth Solutions, straitsmouthsolutions.com, and let's talk about evaluating airway in a lateral cephalometric x-ray. And I've got two x-rays here, or drawings that I made of x-rays, just so you could see the anatomy a little bit better. On the left, we have an adult with no obvious adenoids present. You can see where the adenoids are on the right side. Usually you'll see this kind of round lump right here. It's bulbous. This is not adenoids you cannot see clinically, okay? They're not possible, but you can see them in an x-ray. The palatine and lingual tonsils can be seen clinically, or usually the palatine, not as much the lingual, but you can definitely see the lingual in the lateral ceph. If you want to see from the oral airway, you know, that going down, you should be able to see some daylight right here. You can see it's almost nothing there. Here, you can see, you can see a little daylight going down right here, but here it's touching, okay? So you can touch this direction. You can also kiss or touch if you check your melon potties inside, you know, by and using a tongue depressor, you can see your melon potty score as well. Usually that's gonna present here as well. Okay, so you can see this is a child. The other thing that we notice with this child is that the child does have a very, quote, SDB kind of profile, SDB look of the face, a longer face, a steeper mandible, a downward and backwards growth instead of a forward growth. Sometimes they have antagonial notching. This is just all very classic signs of airway issues caused by either tonsils or adenoids issues. So it is something you want to screen, because you cannot correct the patient orthodontically if they do not have a proper airway. They're always going to be growing the wrong direction. So this is something that you want to flag in little kids, 3s, 4s, 5s, 6s, 7s, and start getting involved. Start getting involved. In May, I have so much content just on working with ENTs about evaluating and treating sleep disordered breathing. This is going to be an interdisciplinary approach. It could involve the patient's physician or pediatrician. It could involve the ENT, that's an ear and ears, nose, and throat physician. Might involve OMT. If there is some mouth breathing and there's tongue thrusting issues as a result, we're going to have to fix up that habit. It's probably going to involve orthodontics. It's probably going to involve their dentist. That's 5 doctors / medical professionals right there. And sometimes it also involves cervical chiro. If there's an issue with all the fascia getting interconnected with the neck and causing, you know, different deviations and things like that. So hopefully this was helpful. I really hope that you are taking lateral cephs for your orthodontic patients. It isn't probably something you're normally gonna take in a 3 or 4 year old, but you know, you might take them in a 7 or 8 year old when you start to see things in your office to help the treatment on this patient, to get the patient the help they need. And just too often, one of the things that drives me absolutely batty is we'll see these kids that maybe have a class 2 kind of bite. They're growing long, they're going backwards, they're going downwards, and doctors are telling them they need headgear. They're taking out teeth, and that's just absolutely insane. What are you doing? You're making this patient's, yeah, maybe you're like, oh, I'm fixing the overjet, but you're making the airway worse. You're making the patient worse. You're making the problem worse. They're growing more in the wrong direction. What you need to do is you need to fix the airway, and then we fix them orthodontically and remove any habits. So hopefully that was helpful. I really hope that you guys, this makes it more clear so that you really start screening these patients when you take your x-rays. Thank you.